going to solve questions. So I think we have discussed all the theory topics from this chapter, and also I have informed you before that this topic is mainly like a problem-based topic. It's not even like you don't need to learn or read more content. What you have to do is you have to solve more problems. All right. So now, first question, question number one. So we will solve. So I have given you like these all are the topics, subtopics. So I will solve all the questions according to the subtopic. So you can also see that I will solve like first from average velocity, speed, and then from acceleration, from equations of motion, like that only. In an order only I'll go. So what you have to do is you have to like follow topic by topic. Alright. So first question, question number one. So I will give the question here. Okay, you can read it from there itself. Okay. And the question number one, a particle covers half of its total distance with speed v1, the rest half distance with v2. Its average speed during the complete journey, we have already discussed the answer, so I am not going to discuss it again. So what is the value? Half of its distance, so it will be 2 v1 v2 divided by v1 plus v2, or V average is equal to total distance traveled divided by d1 plus d2 divided by d1 by v1 plus d2 by v2. Okay, that is the equation. That is the general equation, and this is what is the equation here, because here both the values are equal. Option C. Next question. A car moves. Second question. A car moves distance of 200 meter. It covers half of its first half of distance with speed 40, second half of the distance with speed v. The average speed is, so I would say it is 60. So the answer is 60. So how did I get it? The thing is, you can apply the same equation. Okay, so this question is like pretty famous. So that is why I said 60 without solving the problem. But look at this. So here V average is given, that is 48 C equal to 2 into what is the first velocity? 40 divided into the V divided by V1 plus V2, that is 40 plus V. Okay, so solve it, then you will get it. Alright, so what you have to do, 40 plus V, let it come here, 40 plus V. So this is how I solve the problem, 40 plus V, here, let it come here, divided by V is equal to 2 into 40 divided by 48. Okay, so here, you can cancel out. So here, 40 divided by V plus 1 is equal to 2 into, it will come 10 divided by 12. So again, you can cancel. 5, 6, again, 3, alright, so 5 by 3, so it will come 40 divided by V is equal to 5 by 3 minus 1, 40 is equal to V, sorry, 40 divided by V is equal to 5 by 3 minus 1, that is 2 by 3, and how much is V? V is equal to 3 into 40 divided by 2, that's equal to 60, alright, so this is the answer. So look at this, this is how we have to solve all the problems of average speed and average velocity. So like I think you might have got it. If you haven't got it, like please go like back and then play it again. Alright, so next question. So the next question, question number 3. Two cars P and Q starts from a rest, sorry, from a point at the same time in a straight line, and their position are represented, are given, like xp of t is given, that is at plus bt square, and xq of t is also given, that is f of ft minus t square. Okay, and at what time do the cars have same velocity? That is the question. So their positions are given, look at this, their positions are given. So we can say that there, first we can find out their velocity. So what is dxp divided by dt? dxp divided by dt is equal to a plus 2bt. And what is dx cube of t divided by dt? That is equal to f minus 2t. So one thing is very clear, like this is the velocity of t and this is the velocity of q. It is given that both are equal. Okay, so we can make them equal. A plus 2bt is equal to f minus 2t. So I can take all the two terms together. So f minus a, let it come here, is equal to 2t outside, 2b plus 2 t outside. Okay, so it will be f minus a divided by 2b plus 2, that is what is t, that is the time, or f minus a divided by 2 into b plus 1. Okay, so you can make it anyways. So the answer which is given, f minus a divided by 2 into b plus 1, option D. Okay, so now the question, next question. Look at that, this is actually a pretty good question. At the displacement x in meter, so that is the fourth question. Right? Yeah. Question number 4. The displacement x of a particle of mass m in kilogram moving in one dimension under the action of force is related to time t by t is equal to root x plus 3. Okay, 3 is outside. The displacement of the particle when its velocity is 0. That is a question. The displacement of the particle when the velocity is 0. So first thing, we have to find out the displacement x in terms of t. It's very easy. We know that t minus 3 is equal to root x. Square both sides. So it will be t minus 3 the whole square is equal to x. Okay. So this is the first thing. This is the first thing. Alright. Second thing, take dx by dt. That is what is velocity. Dx by dt is equal to 2 into t minus 3. 2 into t minus 3. And what is given in the question? The displacement of the particle when the velocity is 0. So make velocity is equal to 0. So make it 0. So then 2 into t minus 3 is equal to 0. Or t is equal to 3 seconds. T is equal to 3 seconds. So at t is equal to 3 seconds, what is the value of displacement? Displacement is equal to t minus 3 the whole square. That is 3 minus 3 the whole square, which is equal to 0. So what is the answer? 0. Okay? The answer is 0, which is given, option B. Alright, so question number 5. A particle moves along the straight line OX at a time t in seconds. The distance x in meters of the particle from O is given by x is equal to 40 plus 12t minus t cube. Okay, so it is given 40 plus 12t minus t cube. Okay, how long would the particle travel before coming to rest? That is the question. So how long this particle travels before coming to rest? This is what is x. Okay, so when it becomes rest, we know that the velocity of the particle is equal to 0. We can just keep it, our velocity is equal to 0. And from the displacement equation, we know that take dx by dt, differentiation. So 40 is 0, 12 minus 3t square is equal to 0. That is, we make velocity is equal to 0. Why? Because in the question which is given, the value before it comes to rest, how much distance travel. So this is the time when it comes to rest. So that is 12 minus 3t square is equal to 0, which implies 12 is equal to 3t square. So 4 is equal to t square, 12 by 3. So t square is equal to plus or minus 2. Since it is time, there is no minus, is not valid. So 2 seconds. 2 seconds is the correct answer. 2 seconds. Alright. So t square is equal to 4 and t is equal to 2 seconds. Alright. So from this it is very clear that
At the time t is equal to 0, velocity will be 0. So before coming to rest, put the value of this here, then you will get the value of x. Then how much distance it has traveled? 40 plus 12 into 2 minus t cube, that is 8. So which is equal to 40 plus 12 into 2, 24 minus 8. How much is that? 40 plus 12 into 64. 64 minus 8, 56. The answer is 56 meters. Is there any option? Yeah, option D. So 56 meters. So next is sixth question number 6.
It's a simple question.
Look at this. Which of the following curves does not represent the motion in one dimension? So all of you check that. All of you check that the pictures, the graphs. So which of them, which is not representing the motion in one dimension? Which one is that? The option B. Okay. Why? Yeah. Take 1-2 seconds and think about it. Why that circle is not like panning?
This is velocity versus time, right?
Why the circle is not valid? Because look at this. So if you consider one time, this is time t is equal to 2 seconds. Look at this. At the same time, it has two velocities. It has two velocities. In one dimensional motion, it is not possible. At the same time, look at this. This body has two velocities. One velocity, this velocity. One velocity, this one. Another one, this one. The same time. So that is not possible. So that is why it is not valid. So this graph is not valid, and the option is B, right? Yes. Okay.